Howdy, how's it going? My name's Davy Chappie, and it's time to get back into the wonderful world of the Warlock by studying all of the things that makes their magic special, the invocations. For this list, I'm not going to be pulling out Davy's Davy meter, because I think that these invocations are all pretty good, and I want to talk a little bit more about each individual choice and let you, the player, decide the usefulness for yourself. Warlocks, as you may have heard in my Warlock video, are the most customizable class in D&D bar none, and the majority of that is due to the sheer amount of invocations that you can choose from, and the various ways that you can mix and match them. So putting them on a scale of what is good and what is not good is silly because warlocks will theme themselves based off of an idea and then build their invocations based off of that. So you're not going to want to listen to what I say anyway. As always, remember that the majority of this is just my opinion. So if you feel like your patron Dav's not giving your invocation the dividends it deserves, then feel free to use your magical stolen power however you'd like. But with that out of the way, let's begin. Agonizing Blast. So this invocation is the centerpiece of warlocks who want to dump everything they can into Eldritch Blast, which makes sense given that it's like the best damaging cantrip in the world. It's sort of useful early on, but once you reach levels where you're blasting more than once a turn, that flat damage really starts to add up. Armor of Shadows. Taking this gives you armor that is just inherently better than all the base light armor, and you have it on forever. If you're not a Hexblade, take this unless you somehow get armor that has bonuses equaling or exceeding 13 plus dex. And if you are a Hexblade, consider whether or not it's worth investing in invocation and a lot more ability score improvements to raise your dex, or if it would just be better to sink the money into half plate and accept that a max dex Hexblade would get exactly one more AC than you. It is actually a legitimate decision to make. Ascendant Step. You'll float too. I really like invocations that work all the time, so always remember that you never really have to stop floating. Aspect of the Moon. To be honest, the DM will hate you if you take this invocation, and will find ways to work around it anyway, so this ability is really just for flavoring, or for really light activity anyway. Beast Speech. Talking to animals is fun, and being able to do it all the time can potentially give you spies in every tree branch. Beguiling Influence. Personally, I think that if you need these proficiencies, you would have already gotten them in the first place, but hey, maybe you just want to be that guy that uses your super awesome invocation slots to get even more proficiencies. Bewitching Whispers. So you can either compel someone towards or away from you, but you can only do it once per long rest, so I don't see this being as useful as the always on invocations. Book of Ancient Secrets. This is the straight upgrade to the Pact of the Tome, and so it is very, very useful. Despite popular belief, warlocks don't start with ritual casting, so being able to take literally every ritual spell from every class not only frees up your spell slots like nobody's business, but also means that you could potentially have more flexibility than the wizard. Chains of Carceri. An at-will hold person, understanding that hold person is a phenomenal spell, is ridiculous, but you can't use it on the same creature twice, and it only works on Celestials, Fiends, or Elementals, so fights against them will make you God tier, and fights against other things will have no use for this. Cloak of Flies. So if you want proficiency in Intimidation, you can find it other ways, but a never-ending aura of constant damage is relatively useful, especially since you don't really need to get rid of it unless you're trying to keep up appearances, so this one really comes down to personal preference. Devil's Sight. Dark Vision is always great for those races without it, but being able to see through magical darkness is a feat that very, very few people can get, so this is one of those top pick invocations. Dreadful Word. I'm not a huge fan of invocations that give you one use spells, but it's still useful to conserve your spell slots by throwing out a wild card. Just remember that it only comes back during a long rest, which is a tad annoying. Eldritch Sight. You can see magic, just in general. It's sort of crazy. Remember that it can't go through most walls, so you really are just using your eyes most of the time. Eldritch Smite. It's like the Paladin Smite, but it's got a knockdown effect, and it definitely can't be used as often as the Paladins can. Now, don't let that stop you from taking it if you want, but be ready for it to eat up your resources like a mofo. Eldritch Spear. In the open, this means that you can be completely safe from almost all forms of combat and still be useful in confined areas like caves, knock out all the lights, and then take superior dark vision somehow to hit people from further away than they can even see you. Eyes of the Runekeeper. Not only will the DM hate you, but now you can talk to any creature, no matter the language, so long as they write everything down and you yourself don't have anything to say. Fiendish Vigor. It's only 5 to 9 ablative hit points, but since you can use it whenever you want, as long as you don't stick your dick out in front of every bad guy you see, you can tank the first hit sent your way without actually getting hurt. And if you start to get low on actual health, then you just have to take every turn after you get hit to recast the spell, and you'll still be able to contribute. Gaze of Two Minds. You know, some people take a familiar for this sort of thing. However, in this case, the versatility and the almost infinite range can make it a far superior choice as long as you're willing to give up an invocation for it. Ghostly Gaze. What bothers me is that this invocation implies that you can see ghosts, but you cannot actually see ghosts. Nevertheless, being able to see through solid objects with your new Byakugan means that you can get the drop on whatever is hiding behind the next door. Or you could act like a 13-year-old with x-ray glasses. Gift of the Depths. Useful for underwater campaigns, but largely unuseful for any other scenario. This one is definitely an invocation that you take when you need it and switch switched out when you don't anymore. Gift of the Ever-Living Ones! Very useful if you like getting healed, which hopefully everyone does. Since your familiar should never be far behind as long as it hasn't been dunked on, you'll make a lot of use out of this invocation. And the longevity that this has paired with fiendish vigor is downright stupid. Grasp of Hadar! Useful for Hexblades, but I'm not sure why other Warlock archetypes would really want someone to get closer to them. Keep in mind, though, that you don't have to pull people in, so this still has good opportunistic value. Improved Pact Weapon! Really, if you have Pact of the Blade, this just gives you a free +1 magic item that can shapeshift into almost any weapon you want, so why in the world wouldn't you take it? Lance of Lethargy! This is my favorite of the movement invocations for Eldritch Blast, since whether someone is running away from you or towards you, reducing their speed by 10 feet is usually just as good as pushing or pulling them the same amount, so this just covers all the bases in one invocation. Life Drinker. Extra damage for your bladed weapon, which coupled with your strength or dex mod makes hitting people with your big stick an actually viable option later down the line. I guess it makes up for the problem of not being able to hit a super amount of times like with the Eldritch Blast. Maddening Hex. It's like the Ranger Slayer ability. Considering that there's really no penalty to spamming this all the time outside of spending your bonus actions, it looks like it's just free damage. Mask of Many Faces. This invocation is immediately accessible, and I hate it so much. The utility of being able to effectively shapeshift whenever you want should go completely unspoken. Master of Myriad Forms, the evolution of Mask of Many Faces. Once you hit level 15, consider trading out the mask for the master, since it does a lot of what you would probably want many faces for anyway, but keep in mind that Mask of Many Faces still creates a new illusion of what you're wearing, so it might be worth it to stick to it anyway. Minions of Chaos. Be very careful about casting the spell that this invocation gives. If your concentration breaks, then you could very well be damning your party right then and there. It's why I don't put much stock into a lot of conjuration spells. Mire the Mind. Slow is one of the best spells in the game, and it's really shocking that so many people don't talk about it. Whip this out against the final boss, and any enemies that have been hit by the effects get to suck for the entire fight. Seriously, just don't lose concentration, and you will be a king. Misty Visions. With this invocation, you can do all the things that people think Minor Illusion can do, like move the image, or actually make a fully sized person. That alone makes this a useful spell. One with the Shadows. With this invocation, you can do all the things that people think rogues can do, like actually turn invisible just because they press themselves up to a shady wall. Good for quick getaways and infiltration quests. Otherworldly Leap. The jump spell has too specific of an application to be picked up instead of any of the other spells on your spell list. This invocation had the chance to make jump a pretty interesting spell. Instead, now I have to contend with being able to cast Levitate all I want, being able to speak with dead people, or being able to jump around a bit. Relentless Hex. This choice will see good use in Hexblades who can use the invocation to cover the gap between them and their targets, but other classes won't see as much traction, since why do you even want to get close to your opponent when you could just not do that and cast Eldritch Blast from 300 feet away? Repelling Blast. Same opinion as Grasp of Hadar. Yes, you could take this to push people away, which is useful in its own right, but generally, slowing people down with Lance of Lethargy will help you a bit more, unless you specifically need to push someone around somewhere. Sculptor of Flesh. Polymorph is a really useful spell, just be wary of the fact that you can only use it once before you need to take a long rest. Nothing is more annoying than casting one of your precious few spells, only to get hit by a rock and accidentally fail your concentration save. Shroud of Shadow. The next step up from One with the Shadows, if you have that invocation, immediately trade it out for this one, because this does everything that can do, and more. Sign of Ill Omen. It's useful and all, but like I said before, be careful that you're not about to lose your concentration right away, or you'll be a sad warlock. Thief of Five Fates. Bane continues to be a really useful spell, just don't get hit. Thirsting Blade. If you took Pact of the Blade, let's just be honest, you're gonna take this feature as well. It literally acts as a second melee attack that literally all of the melee fighters get at 5th level, which for some reason makes me chuckle whenever I see it in invocation form. Tomb of Levistus. It'll save you in a pinch. Some people say that the spell is lame because it takes away your next turn, but to them I say that you will lose a lot more turns if you're dead. Also, keep in mind that fire damage vulnerability only comes into effect after the initial damage, so if your trigger is fire damage, it's only gonna do its normal amount. Trickster's Escape. I personally don't think that this invocation is useful enough to warrant taking a long rest to get it back. Maybe a short rest, but I don't see myself getting trapped often enough to believe that dedicating one of my 8 precious slots into it will be totally worth it. Visions of Distant Realms. You get Gaara's weird sand eye thing. It's really useful for spying on people, and means that you will never ever get trapped by a trap again. Voice of the Chain Master. It basically gives you infinite range on that whole perceive through your familiar senses that the Find Familiar spell does, and if you pick an imp which can turn invisible, you in essence get the Visions of the Distant Realms ability at first level instead of 15, with the only downside being that your actual body still has to not do anything while you're using your familiar sight. Whispers of the Grave. You can talk to dead people. It makes interrogations real easy. Witch Sight. Very niche. When it's useful, it's really useful. When it's not really useful, it's completely useless for the vast majority of the time. Still, some people like seeing invisible creatures all the time. But that'll about do it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe, like, comment, ring the bell, tip your waitress, and have a nice day. But yeah, Davy out.